Yes, children, welcome back. We are continuing the third video to be sent on the third week of November. This is based on the chapter Heredity, and this is assignment based video to be sent this week. Okay, now after having the discussion about the first MCQ in detail, and you have got the idea about the visible contrasting plate. You got the idea. Now you got the idea about the variations, how the variations develop in an organism. Now after that, we have studied the genotype of a human female. How to write the genotype of human female. Now after that, we have discussed the chromosomes which determine the characters other than the sexual characteristics, that are autosomes. So autosomes are characteristics that determine the characters of the body other than the sexual characteristics. Now we are coming to the fifth one. You know, gametogenesis. Gametogenesis is the formation of male and female gametes. After puberty, the male and female start producing the gametes. Everybody knows. The male gametes are called sperms. Sperms. Or we can also say anthrozoids in lower plants. Anthrozoids or sperms. Clear? Right. And in females, it is egg or ovum. Okay, we have already studied the gametes formed during this sexual reproduction in males and females. It means that the sperms and the eggs formed in the reproductive organs of the male and female is haploid in nature. Haploid. What is the meaning of haploid? H-A-P-L-O-I-D. What is the meaning of haploid? Yes. We are now coming to the fifth question now. Haploid. Haploid means half set of chromosomes. Haploid. H-A-P-L-O-I-D. Haploid means half set of chromosomes. Half set of chromosomes. Half such a chromosome will be represented by n, small n in bracket. You will write in bracket, okay, not the circle. So half n represents the haploid set. In all the sperms and the eggs, we can say otherwise, the sex cells, sperms and eggs contain haploid number of chromosomes. Half such a chromosome, which is represented by n. What is the reason for this? How this haploid set develops? Haploid set develops from the diploid mother cell. Okay, it is mother cell, egg mother cell and sperm mother cell. Mother cell, he said, they are diploid. Egg mother cell or sperm mother cells are diploid. You know that. Diploid. Diploid mother cell undergoes a type of subdivision. What is the name of the subdivision? Meiosis. So meiosis is a cell division which takes place only in the diploid cells. Not only the sperm and egg diploid mother cells. It can also take place in the diploid cells, whatever that we have, but mainly we have diploid cells in which the meiosis cell division takes place in the reproductive cells, that are diploid mother cells. Okay, that are sperm mother cell and egg mother cell, which undergoes meiosis, that is cell division and form. Haploid. Because of this chromosome number, suppose the chromosome number is 46. Diploid is 46, of course. Then haploid will be 23. So the chromosome number is reduced to half. This is the reason why the meiosis is called a reduction division. Why meiosis is called a reduction division? Because during this meiosis, the chromosome number reduced to half. That's the reason why the gametes formed by meiosis have only what? Half number of chromosomes.
half number of chromosomes. I hope you got it. Very clear? Very clear. Yes. Any doubt you can discuss in the live class. Now, sixth question. In a normal case, the zygote formed during sexual reproduction gets dash gene from each parent. Yes, we know that. We have studied during sexual reproduction. The zygote is formed. Zygote is a combination of the egg and the sperm. So egg carry 50% of the half number of the chromosomes from the mother, and the sperm carry 50% of the chromosomes from father. So egg 50% and the sperm 50%. So each parent share 50% of the genetic material. So that the zygote formed by the fusion of the sperm and the egg contain 100% of the genetic material. In this way, the genetic material get inherited from the parents to the offspring. You got this idea? It's very clear, but yes, very clear. Now, if you have doubt, you can discuss in the live class. Now, seventh question. There are large pairs of autosomes in each of the body, each of the cells in the body of an organism. Yes, we can say there are large pairs of autosomes in each of there are large pairs of autosomes. How many pairs of autosomes? Yes, we have a 22 pair of autosomes. 22 pair. It means that 44 autosomes. 44 in total. We write 24 pair means 44 autosomes. And in the gamete, you have the number. Of course, it will be reduced. How many type? How many number of the autosomes? 22. 22 number. 22 number autosomes. It means that 11 pair of autosomes. You got this idea? Very clear? Very clear. Yes, now come to the last eighth word. Genotype of human female. Yes, genotype of human male. We have already written and studied the genotype of human female. And now we are studying the human male. Genotype of human male. What is that? Only one change, only one chromosome, Y chromosome. Instead of X chromosome, we get Y chromosome. So we can understand that 44 autosomes plus XY sex chromosomes make up the genotype of the human males. I hope you got this idea, and more discussion can be done at the time of live class or during live class. All the best.